Hi, I am Travis from TMK Interactive. For the past year, most of our shows have lived in this type of environment where each actor has been confined to their own little rectangle on screen. This brings up some issues such as how do you look at the other actors and interact with them in a natural way? And also, how do you hand off objects to one another? So we've come up with some ways to bridge the gap, such as using a green screen for a virtual background, but nonetheless, we're still stuck in this rectangle land. So today, let's take a deep dive and explore how we can finally bring our actors together virtually as if they are in the same scene together. And we'll be able to do this all in real time. This video is going to be divided into multiple sections. First, we're going to briefly cover some of the software choices and the theory behind it. We are then going to dive into the tutorial on how to get this running on your computer. If you are here just for the specific topic, you can use the chapter markers in the description below to jump to a certain point and time in the video. First, let's discuss some of the software tools that we are going to be using. I am a huge fan of open source projects, as they do not cost anything to use. This project is primarily going to focus on OBS and OBS.ninja. OBS is a great open source broadcasting software and will act as the heart of our show. We can mix all of the videos together, inject sound effects, and manage scenes. Unlike Zoom, we're gonna have a lot more control over every aspect of the show. We need a way to get the videos from our actors into OBS. This is where OBS Ninja comes in. It is an open source website that allows us to capture remote webcams and access them with their feeds within OBS. And those are the only two things software-wise that we're gonna need to pull this off. We're gonna need some way to remove background from each of the actors' shots. The easiest way to do this is by using a green screen. When it comes to green screens, there are a couple of things that we need to keep in mind. The green screen should be as green as possible and not have any wrinkles or differences in the colors across the surface. This will make the keying process within OBS much easier later. If you're brand new to virtual theater, you can check out my previous video titled Virtual Theater in 2021, which has some basic tips on producing a virtual show. There are two ways to use OBS.ninja to collect our footage. There's one that's similar to a Zoom room where you can see all the other actors, and there's one where it just captures the remote camera. If you're using a room within OBS Ninja, this will require a very strong internet connection for all the participants. This is because it uses a technology called peer-to-peer. In a peer-to-peer network, if you have two people, each one of them have to share the video with each other, but if you add a third person, each person now has to share it with the other two. Likewise, if you add another person, now you have to share, each person has to share to three locations. And as you can see, the network requirements for every participant grows with every person involved. So keeping the number of active participants under six is a good idea. There's a way around this, however, which we'll go over during the tutorial portion. Now let's go ahead and jump over to the computer and start getting things set up. Okay, now that we're on the computer, let's start by downloading OBS. Go ahead and navigate to obsproject.com. Here's where we can find the software, and we're just going to want to click on the type of computer we have, whether it's Windows, Mac, or Linux. I've already done this and installed it on my computer, so go ahead and pause the video if you need some time. After OBS is installed, go ahead and open it up and you'll be presented with something that looks like this. I already dropped in an image just by taking an image off my desktop and dragging it in. But otherwise, OBS is fairly simple. You have the big viewport here, which will show the scene. You have your scenes lists over here and your video sources. We now want to go ahead and grab our remote actor's video source. So to do this, we're going to have to head over to obs.ninja, which is an online open source service. Heading over back over to the web browser, we're going to go to obs.ninja, and this will pull up this website. And there are a couple of different options to getting your actor's footage into OBS. The First one, which is the simplest, is if you just need to get one or two remote cameras in, you can just click add your camera to OBS. And of course, the actor on their computer will be doing this. So they will click on that. And then they can select their camera. In my case, I have an external camera plugged in, so I'm going to choose that. And here I am. But you can go ahead and select your webcam here if you have so. And then you can also select your audio source. And if you're talking, you can see the preview here, and it looks all good. So we're going to click on Start. And this will start up OBS.ninja, collecting the footage. So now we need to actually add this source into OBS. So heading back over to OBS, under the Sources section, we want to hit the plus icon down here. And then we're going to want to add a browser source. We can give it a name if we want. I'll call mine Travis and click on OK. The very next thing we want to do is we need to grab the link from the actor. So we're going to come up here, and for this version, they can click here and it'll copy it to your clipboard. They can paste it and send it to you over a message or email or whatnot. And then once you get that link, you are going to want to paste it in this box here for URL. Next, we want to choose the width and height of the image. And usually with webcams, it's 1280 is the height and 1280 is the width, 720 is the height. And we also want to go ahead and check control audio via OBS. And this will allow us to mix the audio from within OBS and even out the levels. And once we're set with that, we can click on OK. And this will go ahead and reach out to the web, and no matter where they are in the world, they will pop up right inside OBS. And so now we have our video here, and I just clicked and dragged to drag this window around. And good, now, but I'm still this rectangle, so how do we actually put me into the scene fully? And that's where the green screen comes in. So I already have the green screen set up. It's not the best green screen over this area. There's lots of bad stuff over here, which shouldn't be there. And we're gonna clean that up as well. And to do that, let's go ahead and, with the video source we just added selected, we're going to click on Filters. And then we're under the Effect Filters, we're going to click the plus icon, and we're going to add a chroma key. You can give it a name if you want, and then click on OK. So this is where we're going to be removing the green screen. First, we can select which color we want to remove, whether we have a green screen or if we have a blue screen, we can change this here. Or select a custom color. So if you do a custom color, you can select a color and then pick what color you have. But for me, I'm just gonna stick with green. Next is similarity. So if you turn the similarity all the way down, nothing's gonna match perfect green, so it's not gonna key anything. But as you increase this, you will start to key out the background. So I usually like to just play around with this until I get something that I think looks good. Smoothness just keeps the smoothness. It sort of smooths out the overall key. So if you turn this all the way down, you'll see the wonderful internet compression. This is sort of internet compression artifacts from OBS Ninja, but thankfully we can smooth that out pretty well. And then that's good in here. So now you'll notice I got some stuff over here that I really don't want to see, and a little thing, or is it down there? So let's go ahead and remove that, and we're going to do that by cropping the image. Thankfully, OBS has a crop thing built right into it. We can add an effect filter called crop pad down here. And this is the number of pixels that we're sort of going to squish the image in from either side. We have the option to do it from the left side, the right side, the top, or the bottom. So on the left side, I'm going to bring it in 50 pixels. And same thing for the right side, I'm going to bring it in 50 pixels. So now you'll notice that I got rid of the sort of the things on the side that I didn't want to see. So now if I close this, we'll see that I'm now have the background keyed out, and I can see the virtual background behind me. The benefit over doing like a zoom virtual background is we can place me anywhere in the scene. So I would make myself a little smaller, and I put myself over here. And in a real performance, you would most likely have the entire body of the actor green screened out. So I'd be standing much further back. But just for this demonstration, I am going to be sitting at my desk here. And That's how you get each actor in. If you had more than one, you'd repeat that process for each actor. But if you're performing a group scene with multiple actors, there's going to be a different way to get the footage into OBS Ninja, and we're going to show you that now. I will leave this video source here, but I'm going to slide back over to OBS Ninja. I'm going to hit the back button to get to the OBS Ninja homepage. And I'm going to click on Create a Room. So this is very similar to, say, like a Zoom room, where you will be able to see the other people and you can perform together. However, we're able to capture the video on the OBS end and edit it all together in real time. First, we just need to give it a room name. I'll call this Test Show Room 1. And if you wanted to give it a password, you're more than welcome to do that. And you're going to click on Enter the Room's Control Center. So this is the control center for the OBS Ninja room. And we need to invite the actors to this room. So thankfully, they give us the link right here. We can copy this link and send it to all of our actors. And this works best when you're using a laptop and using Google Chrome. I've run into some issues with Safari, so sticking with Chrome for now is the best practice. So once they get the link, they will open that up. And they can select whether they want to join the room with the camera, or they could share the screen if they have video content or something that they wanted to share. But for me, I'm going to join with my camera. And I am going to select my virtual camera again. And also, when you're doing rooms, they can select the speaker that they want the audio to come through, because once again, we can talk to them. So we're going to click on Start. And right now, since I'm the only one in the room, similar to Zoom, if you're the only one in the room, it's just you're going to be staring at yourself. But if someone else were to join this, it would split it into two. And if the third person, it'd split into three, and so on and so forth. So you'd be able to perform with the other people. So now, we don't actually need to send anything to the person who created the room. So if we jump back over to the tab where we created the room, so now we're back sort of on the OBS side. We have access to this link right here. We can click on it to copy it. And we can double click on here. And I'm just going to change this link to here. And once again, when we get a second, we should see me again. So here I am, I'm back here. And that's sort of how you get people into OBS. And going over the room, one more thing I wanted to mention is as more people join using this guest invite link, there'll be more and more of these cards that show up, and you'll be able to see each individual person and copy each individual video feed and move that into OBS. And then you also have options to send someone a message, you can mute them remotely, you can turn off their video, and there's also similar features as Zoom where you can have like a group chat among all people in case you wanted to run queues of any sorts. So that is how you get your actors into Zoom. You can create multiple scenes and then do this configuration for each scene, and you can cycle through the scenes. This is the basic version. If you wanted more of a studio feel, you can click on studio mode, and this will give you something more akin to like a video switcher if you're used to that sort of world. For each video that we're getting in remotely, we have the option to control the audio here, which is very nice. We can mute them, or we can control the individual audio levels from each of our remote actors. And lastly, once we're ready to go live to the web, we can just click on Settings and going to Stream. This is where we're going to enter the RTMP server settings, and this will be provided to you by the streaming provider. And with that, I think I'm going to wrap up. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments below, or if you have any suggestions for future videos, I'm always open to taking suggestions for things that you guys would like to see. If you appreciated this, go ahead and like and subscribe if you feel like it. And thank you very much. I'll see you next time.